So we're here with Revée Walcott-Nolan in the beautiful St Moritz surroundings. You're just getting ready to head to Doha for your season opener. How are you feeling, and how's the winter going since the indoor season?
The winter's gone really well, no complaints. Training's been really good, so I'm excited to open up.
Yeah. And what's training been like this winter? Have you been doing anything sort of differently, or how does it feel compared to, say, last year?
No, compared to last year, yeah, quite different. I've been doing a lot more volume-based work, a lot more threshold, a lot more volume. So compared to last year, my training has jumped up quite a bit.
Yeah, and are you starting to feel the effects of that now, or is sort of the weekend when you answer a few questions?
Yeah, I think the weekend I'll kind of know, but I'm feeling really good, so yeah, I think this training's definitely quite well suited to me.
Yeah, and what's the setup like here? Obviously, you've had a little bit of time to sort of settle in now. It was a big change for you at the time, but are you starting to sort of get used to things and get your head around things a bit more?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like I've settled in quite well, so yeah, everything's just the new norm now. So
yeah. What's life like sort of training with Thomas and the group?
Oh, it's so good. I didn't have a group before, so now being in this kind of group setup is really such a difference to having to do everything by yourself.
Yeah.
It makes everything a lot easier, so yeah, I'm enjoying it.
Yeah, what are the biggest differences that you're finding, and what's been the biggest help?
I think just like having a team of people around you that are all like aiming for the same goals. I think before, where I was literally doing everything by myself, it's really hard to kind of stay in the zone, stay motivated, whereas now it's quite natural because we're all in it together.
Yeah, because I guess a few sort of distance athletes talk about having to, I guess, get used to the boredom, or almost like the repetition of what you have to do. Is that so much easier when you have people to sort of share that experience
with? Yeah, so much easier. Like even before, my training schedule was kind of, I'd get up whenever I wanted, train, and then train in the evening whenever I wanted. So I was just all over the place. Like I'd be training at midday and then like second run at 8 p.m. It was just like whenever I wanted to, I was just doing it, and it wasn't really working too well. But now we have a schedule that we all stick to, and it is a lot better.
Is there a part of you then that sort of looks back and think, how did I do that? How was I operating like that?
Yeah, all the time I'm like, how did I do that for like so many years? But yeah, I think I obviously didn't want to quit, so that was kind of my only option at the time to get it done like that.
What do you think it was that kept you going then, if that's, you know, as you say, you didn't want to leave the sport behind?
It's
because it's not an easy sport to be a part of.
I think just knowing that like I hadn't achieved what I think I can in the sport, and I feel like I'm not a quitter really. Like if I want to achieve something, I really don't want to quit until I have. So yeah, I think just having that in the back of my head, knowing that I hadn't done like anywhere near as much as I wanted to in the sport, just kind of kept me going.
Yeah, and with On's involvement as well, how are they as a brand to work with, and how much support have they given you?
Oh, so good. I feel like the support they give every one of their athletes is like unmatched. Like I've never experienced that from another brand or heard about any other brand supporting their athlete as much as On do for theirs. So yeah, I think that was really important for me when I was signing, that I was joining a brand that looked out for their athletes and really wanted to support them.
Yeah
I found it.
Yeah, and it's a big summer ahead. You know, another Olympic year, and also will you be aiming for Europeans as well?
Yes, yeah, I will be, so hopefully.
Yeah, so how do you feel going into this Olympic summer sort of compared to sort of Tokyo?
Completely different, to be fair. I think Tokyo was, obviously, I had hopes of making the team, but I think I was on like 4:15 personal best for the 1500. and the standard was 4.4, so I had quite a way to go. But then I managed to get down to 4.6, so I feel like that year I gave it everything to make the team, but I still, in the back of my head, I knew that it was going to be a hard task. Whereas this year, I feel like it's slightly easier because I'm a lot closer to the time. But yeah, it's still, the depth in middle distance 1500 running is insane at the moment. So yeah, it's going to be tough, but I feel a lot more prepared.
Yeah, I was going to say the 1500 just now, just across both women's and men's events is crazy. Is that, you know, exciting to be a part of? Is the part of you that sort of relishes that rather than being sort of fearful of it?
No, it is exciting. I feel like it pushes each one of us to run faster, because I feel like half the task is making the team, but then you've got to get to the champs and perform. And I feel like as we're all pushing each other on to run faster, that only like bodes well for how we're going to compete at major champs.
Yeah, is there anyone that sort of inspires you that you watch particularly closely?
Not really, if I'm being honest. I feel like I'm just inspired by the girls that I compete against, like just wanting to be at that level, competing with them.
Yeah, and with the Olympics coming up, you know, what kind of expectations do you have of yourself going into this summer, and what would success look like for you this year?
I feel like I have quite high expectations of myself this year, like more so than ever, but I don't want to like set myself too many limits, because I feel like the consistency I've had this last year has been really good. And I don't really know how that's going to translate, but I know I can run fast, so I'm just kind of just going with the flow at the moment. But yeah, I have high expectations in my head, but I don't want to set limits really.
Has finding that consistency, you know, been one of the key things? Because, you know, so many athletes talk about that. It's not necessarily the flashy stuff that's the important bit. It's getting that foundation in place.
Yeah, 100%. I think consistency for me has been like the major thing to why I've been running well, because before I've not had that at all. Like I've been training well, but then something comes up and then you take 2 weeks off, and then it was non-stop, like illness, had a few injuries, but more so just like not being able to stay healthy, which stopped me from getting that consistency. But this last year I think I maybe had a cold indoors for like a week. Apart from that, I've had no issues, touch wood. So, yeah.
Well, best of luck and thank you very much.